It's December the 1st, and I'm starting to hurt, 'cause I can't get a date for New Year's.
20 years later, the neatest sound of the 50s from the neatest guys of the 50s come back to life in a spectacular new album.
Who made the eggs, salad sandwiches?
50 of the neatest hits from 5 of the neatest guys. Yes, it's the 5 neat guys' neatest hits. Remember, let's have a party in my rec room.
Let's have a party in my rec room.
And on the same album,
I won't date just any girl around, 'cause Patsy has the largest breasts in town.
Yes, Patsy has the largest breasts in town. You'll also hear, should I kiss her goodnight? My mom framed my high school diploma, slow dance anyone, and she does it.
Does it, she does it. The whole town says she does it.
You'll also hear, my dad's car, let's have a party in my rec room, who put the pennies in my loafers, and I'm the goof in the classroom.
I'm the goof in the classroom.
Songs from 5 of the world's neatest guys. It's K-Tel's 5 Neat Guys' Neatest Hits.
5 thugs pulled my tie from my collar, so don't step on my clip-on tie.
It's 5 Neat Guys' Neatest Hits.
Just step around that clip-on tie.
Record $8.95, paper cassette $15.95.
Tired of ordinary television? Don't touch that dial. SCTV is now on the air. Starring John Candy, Joe Flaherty, Eugene Levy, Andrea Martin, Rick Moranis. Thomas. Television like you've never seen it before. This is the SCTV Television Network with special guest Levon Helm.
It's One on the Town with Earl Cannonbear.
Nothing affects our everyday lives more than music does. We hear it on our phonographs, on our car radio, in elevators, and yes, even on these weird things. Music is a multi-billion dollar industry, but the people who make it happen are not your typical gray flannel suit set. They're the musicians, the artists dedicated to their profession, to their music, and to the road. Tonight, One on the Town takes an exciting behind-the-scenes look at one such musician. Levon Helm, former member of the band, star of A Coal Miner's Daughter, and currently playing here in town in the midst of a grueling two-month 35-city tour. I'll be talking to Levon about what it's like being on the road, and I'll try and find out just what makes this man tick. That and much, much more as One on the Town meets Levon Helm.
I just can't talk with you right now.
Okay, Colonel, we're running a little bit late.
The boys got to do a sound check. We got to eat. Hang loose. I'll get to you.
Just a couple of questions. Well, there you have it. Levon Helm, musician, on the road, running behind, a little late. Have to do a sound check. That's checking the sound, I guess, for the... Got it.
So what do you want to do now?
Let's hang loose. The man said hang loose. I'm sure he's going to be back out. We'll, just hang loose.
Yuri Razmanovich, the 400-pound Russian Olympic weightlifting champion, amazed the world last year by deadlifting 850 pounds. Now Yuri comes to SCTV in his very first television variety special, Yuri, Getting to Know You.
Getting to know you, getting to know all about you. Getting to like you, getting to hope you like me.
With Yuri's special guest, Dolly Parton.
I bet you take plenty steroids. You look like you got stereo steroids.
Special guest, Fred Astaire.
Putting on the coffins.
Hey, Fred!
And a guest appearance by Yuri's friend, Rodney Dangerfield.
No, I don't have any luck with women at all, you know? No, my wife, she's no bargain either. Last week, she told me to take out the garbage. She's always trying to fix me up with dates, you know? I don't know, you know? Oh,
I tell you, Mr. Dangerfield, you're a beautiful man.
I don't even get no respect from a big, fat Russian communist, you know?
A big, fat Russian communist. We'll be right back with more respect after this.
He's great. I love him. Yuri, ladies and gentlemen.
Respect.
Yuri, yeah.
No respect. Now I will be American faith healer. Heal.
There'll be lots of that special Yuri Razmanovich humor.
Because of all.
So for a fun-filled hour of music, comedy, and weightlifting, join Yuri and all his friends on Yuri, Getting to Know You. SCTV Television Network.
You are so beautiful. To me.
Good afternoon. Welcome all of you to you. And thank you all very much for your response to yesterday's show on bikini waxing. We're going to give you the phone number to Lena, the best bikini waxer in town. 5 months, not a single hair grew back. I was a poodle when I went in there. Then I'm in Acapulco, not a single hair. Anyway, I'm repeating myself. Call Lena, 555-5555. Call her. She's a doll. You won't be sorry. Anyway, a couple of notes on next week's show. Next week, all week, nails and lashes. Trina from Mary Nietzsche does me. She's coming here. She's great. She's the best one there. In fact, I said to her, Trina, why don't you open your own place? She said, what for? Look at Mary Nietzsche. She opened her own place, had a kid. Now she won't do a nail or a lash. She said, what if I want to have a kid? I said, oh, please, please. I got enough problems. Anyway, enough of that. Today, we have got a show for you. Dr. Saul Rubin, psychiatrist, is with us to talk about a problem that affects so many of us women today. Women's problems. Good afternoon, Dr. Rubin. Welcome. Have a seat. There. All right, let's get right to it.
Hello. How are you?
Very good. What in your mind today is the biggest problem that women face today?
Well, Libby, as you know, women face a wide range of problems and have right through time. Our mothers and our mothers' mothers all suffered a wide variety of problems, certainly indigenous to women, but I think we're correct in focusing in on the woman's problem, the woman in the 80s, the woman who is saying, hey, I'm aware that I'm living in a man's world, I'm prepared to cope with it, but I want to change it.
What about weight? How does weight fit in?
Weight as a woman's problem.
You see a lot of women who are fat.
Well, I have a lot of patients who are women, and many of whom suffer similar patterns of compulsive behavior. Some are overweight and some are anorexic.
I would kill to be anorexic for 1 week. Can I tell you that? Anyway, continue.
Well, I...
Why can I not stop eating? You're a doctor. You should know. If there were a roll here, I would have eaten it. Is that not sick?
Well, I understand your problem. I think many people have similar problems. But I believe you're a healthy woman. I mean, you burn a lot of energy through your career.
Is that bad?
No, that's good.
Well, you're probably right. It's not serious. You don't think I'm too fat?
Well, I wouldn't really say that.
Why do you keep doing that?
What?
Moving away. Is my breath bad? Did it stink? I had an onion for lunch. Is my... I'm sorry, doctor. Continue. Women's problems.
Well, I was just going to talk about the fact that the feminist movement had somewhat caused a backlash and that men had actually...
Why do you keep doing that?
What?
Rubbing your eye. Do I have something in my eye?
No, that's just kind of just a nervous habit of mine, I guess.
Oh, I am sorry. We are out of time. Dr. Rubin, what can I say? You are fantastic. This has been so enlightening. Thank you so much, Dr. Rubin, and thank you for watching. Next week, Nails and Lashes, please be here. And remember,
you
are so beautiful,
beautiful
to me. Did you think I was serious when I said anorexic? I wasn't serious. People are going to think I'm crazy. Do you think I'm neurotic, or do I just have an edge?
No.
What is this? Did you see me going like that?
What?
Is that food?
No, that's... Ow! That's my beard.
Did you mean it to be like that?
Yes.
I don't think it works.
Hi, man. If you're like me, you'll probably agree that late-night comedy is becoming as common and predictable as the primetime dribble it's supposed to be superior to. Let's face it. We've all had enough of those irreverent young comedians who attack and satirize a world they barely understand. Well, instead of waiting for an alternative to be delivered to you by the network, why don't you make the first move with the Slappy 2000. Yes, the Slappy 2000 is a state-of-the-art programmable home comedy center with a hands-on capability that allows you to choose the kind of comedy you want when you want it. Whether it's cheap old jokes...
Bad Mike at a funeral home looking at the corpse. Bad says he looks good. Mike says he should. He just got out of the hospital.
Or classic put-downs.
Nice hair, Jack. Is that a rug or a squirrel waiting for takeoff?
Or maybe conceptual head humor is more your bag.
You ever notice the warnings on the back of milk cartons that says, do not open this in? What I want to know is what happens if you did. Does it blow up? Do the milk carton police break down your door? Okay.
Well, not all of it works. Yes, the Slappy 2000, a state-of-the-art alternative to late-night television comedy, and the only home comedy center with the self-mocking capability.
I grew up in a bad neighborhood. Bad neighborhood.
Yes, the Slappy 2000 home comedy center. Home comedy center. Commercial parodies. Satire TV. Oh, brother.
The announcer walks out of frame. Walks out of frame.
Everybody, the term overindulgence has become applicable to every facet of American life.
Mr. Wells likes his cocoa van prepared with real cocoa.
Well, it smells fantastic.
Yes, sir.
Breadstick, Mr. Wells.
Getting smaller, aren't they, Antonio?
A look at the whims and appetites of the affluent, soon on Gene Challenge America.
Okay, Ron?
Real good, Levon.
Perfect. Sound okay, fellas? Let's get us a quick nap. Something to eat.
The road. Being on the road. Is being on the road tough on your family? Is being on the road tough on your... That's a good one. Tough on your family.
This fall on SCTV, G. Gordon Liddy, Will, the movie.
Another time I had the president's ear, I showed him how to hunt chipmunks with an Ingram Mach-10 submachine gun. I say we string him up with piano wire.
No. Well, another thing, this Sandinista thing in Nicaragua, they're getting out of hand. What do we do with this samosa? Option, sound off. Egg?
I say we support the opposition party.
Henry?
I say we talk.
Gordon?
String him up with piano wire. Look, either we're in this for all the marbles or we may as well forget it.
Another thing, we have these two cub reporters from the Washington Post, Woodward and Bernstein.
Steed.
They're trying to dig up the dirt on this Watergate caper. Options.
I never read the Washington Post. I find the print to be too small. And there are not enough pictures.
I say let's talk.
I say we get some agents to plant some top secret A-bomb plans on them, turn them over to the military police.
It'll blow their national security clearance.
Great idea. Great idea, Gordon.
Then string them up with piano wire.
I don't think so. Look, another thing. We've got to deal with these. Come here.
Food's here.
Oh, goody. Chow time, USA.
Who's in charge here?
I am. Put that down here.
Oh, sorry, there you go.
All right, who had the turkey? Hey, you had the turkey? All right, Henry, what did you have?
The local blitz.
Local blitz, coming up. All right, and Gordon, you had the rat burger. And I had the fish. And let's see, who had the slaw? Who had slaw? Henry, you have slaw? Okay, and who ordered the fries? Egg. Okay. And let's see, Gordon, you had the rat popover. And I have the gherkin. And let's see, who ordered dessert?
Not me.
We've got an apple brown ratty here. Who ordered? Come on, somebody, gentlemen, ordered an apple brown ratty. Who was it? Gordon, was it you?
No. You can burn my hand till the cows come home. I'll never admit that I had the apple brown ratty. Come on, you want to burn my hand?
No, that won't be necessary, Gordon. That won't be necessary. We'll cover it. Gordon, is there any money left over in that slush fund?
About $100,000.
You got change for $1,000?
No, I don't.
Hey, Tipper.
Oh, thanks, Stanley.
Oh, big Tipper.
What a bunch of humorless guys. I was just kidding. I ordered the apple brown ratty, but only because they were out of cherry cheese rat cake and rat cobbler.
G. Gordon Liddy. Will. The movie.
Summertime blues. get some cheeseburgers. I'll only be gone a minute, so don't screw up.
Is there an Earl Cannon Bear out here?
I just throw on the cheeseburgers.
Well, leave Levon's waiting for you guys in here. Come on, let's do it.
Come on in, fellas. I don't think our buddy Earl is going to show up. Why don't you just turn your camera on there and we'll lay down a few stories. Maybe there'll be something you can use. And tell Earl I hate it worse than any of us.
Can I get two cheeseburgers?
Yes.
I'm going to... Wait a minute. I'm sorry.
Well, please. Did y'all ever hear the joke about the billion-dollar computer? The government puts up $1 billion and they work on this computer night and day for months and months. It's going to have the output of a genius. So the big day comes and everybody's gathered around to see the thing work. And they try it and they shove an important question into the thing. They just back out a bunch of garbage. They can't figure it out. They try again. It sputters out a bunch of other garble. They finally figure that they've got one of these little transistors turned backwards. So, of course, the opposite of genius is moron. So they got fed up and everything, and they wrote on a note and said, to hell will you, we're going home. And it spit back its first answer, said, y'all come back now, you hear?
Can I buy that out here, please?
Earl Cannon Bear will return next week with more insightful interviews on One on the Town. Coming soon to SCTV on the Midnight Express special, it's John Denver. Anne Murray. Randy Newman. And direct from Istanbul, Wolfman Jack. Coming soon to SCTV.